conference. My name is Christian Fedor. I'm what some people call an experiencer, but in terms of alien and extraterrestrial sightings and things like that. Anyways, but that's not what this video is about. This video is about a near-death experience that I had when I was 7 years old back in my country, which is Chile. Anyways, so this is going back to that time when I was 7 years old. It was summer. We were basically going for a trip, you know, closer to where the mountains are in Chile, to a small river. Anyways, thing is that my near-death experience involves ETs. The previous year before I was seven, at the same location, I mean my uncle, my brother, and everybody else that came with us saw a UFO that was an orange plasma ball at about 100 or so meters away, at about 50 meters off the off the top of the trees thereof. And it was there suddenly while we were actually, we noticed this thing because it was the only thing in the sky at around, what was it, 9 p.m. and we were having supper with a little bonfire that we'd made next to the tents where we were that we were using. And my uncle pointed at the eastern side of the sky where the mountains are, and there was this huge plasma ball. Anyways, without going into too much detail, it was there for, I would say, at least 10 minutes to when it began, let's say, popping out all these other smaller lights, much smaller, right? Very, very small. It would look like a swarm of bees was coming out of the plasma ball, and they were all very white in terms of color. So they were very different to the orange red plasma ball that had all the, it also had an opalescence to it because it seemed to rotate in colors almost like a rainbow around it, but more chaotic. So there was the plasma ball, and all the little lights began coming out of it and flying like crazy. And it was in my mind, I remember clearly saying to myself, it's like they're putting on a show for all the people. And the people, well, they were stunned, but some people were also screaming. Yeah. And this got crazy because these lights began to do all kinds of things. Like just go everywhere and shoot off into the distance and come back. And my uncle Louis, he panicked and told us to get in the tent. That's all I remember about that sighting, but my brother still remembers it too. Anyways, that's not what it's about, but it's at the same location. Okay, so the year after this, we went there again. Right. I actually had a near drowning, but I actually passed out underwater. I remember my mom said to me not to go near that area. She was going over there to talk and have a smoke with one of my aunties, my auntie Monica, right? And I could see my mom down, further down this river, talking near the rocks, right? And I really wanted to go there because my uncle Louis was taking care of me, but not in a very fun way, where he was like putting me under the water, playing with me, and I was taking him water because he was just being so rough. So I had enough of him, and I just went to where my mom was. So I went to that side of the river, and as soon as I did that, the current took me, and I started going down an area where the water crushes down, so it becomes white water, and it revolves in there. So I fell into one of those, and I kept on being pushed down. So as I'm drowning, I can feel the cold water, basically filling up lungs, and the fact that you try and breathe when you're just, you're in this mental panic, and you're trying to breathe like that, and you can't because your lungs are kind of stiff because they're full of water. You can't move them, and you can feel that the water is filling up your, cooling down your chest. And I'm trying to fight it, and I'm trying to breathe, and I'm just taking more water. Dude, I think this is not gonna work. I give up. I literally said I give up. I'm letting go. And as soon as I did that, everything became dark and then white, but this beautiful white. And it was kind of like above me, as if I was looking at. But I remember clearly that this was a woman that was in this white light. And she was saying to me, remember. I'm not sure if it was in Spanish or English, but back then I spoke Spanish. But the idea is, remember. And suddenly I began to see my 7 years of life just go in front of me in reverse, but I could see into it as if I was there. I remember when my all these silly things about being a kid, about my father who disappeared because of political reasons, and I remember being a baby and being put in the bathtub. I remember climbing on the kitchen by, onto chairs and getting the Milo out of the cupboards, top cupboards. And but the one thing I remember the most about the life review is a very important thing, I guess. It was something that I remember clearly back then when I would say 4 years old, maybe young, maybe 3 or 4 years old, that what is known as the hooded blue aliens would come to my room. And I didn't know that this is what they were or what they're known to be now. Okay, thanks to the movie Communion, which I guess was written by Willis Strieber, and it's the main actor is Christopher Walken. Anyway, so these beings, not much taller than like 4.5 feet, right? They would usually come as spheres of light right through the wall, zip, and move around, and they come down. As they come down closer and closer to the floor, they become these hooded guys, right? The thing was that I remember clearly this searing pain on my abdomen, where they would, I could not stand that pain. I would usually pass out because of that pain. It's like cold. It's so cold. It just hurts, So I used to dread this thing, and for them to come and touch my abdomen and do whatever it is that they were doing. But the thing is, I even tried bringing I was 4 years old, and I brought in this female German Shepherd that we call Laika. I was like, yeah. Anyways, and I tried to keep the dog in the room, but as soon as this thing happened, I woke up because it yelped, and I knew that they were coming, and it just got out of the room. But what to this day, I couldn't understand why is it that I would not get out of the room. So it's either I was just there frozen in fear, or I just didn't want to move. But anyways, my near-death experience involves all of that, as well as the life review. And this is what's, I guess, it may seem interesting to any of you guys listening out there, is that I've had UFO sightings since I can remember, many of them. And my country, I guess, is known for the UFOs, because it's like they're always seen. There's always sightings there. And by the way, by now, like in this day and age, that same area where I had that near-death experience and my first UFO sighting with other people, with witnesses, that is known in terms of tourism, it's known as area number one, that's in like the hot spot number one for UFO sightings, you know? If you want to go and see UFOs in South America, you go there, specifically in Chile, okay? Anyways, a lot of people say that you become very sensitive, but I've always been an artist, so I'm not sure whether my ability to draw, paint, and play music, or the psychic abilities, comes from that experience, from the NED, or it's because of maybe the contact with the entities, right? Because I've had further contact many years later, to the extent of an implant, and I'll talk about that in a more organized way in the next video, okay? So I hope you enjoyed this short story. It is true, and I've got proof. So the thing is that I've had many other experiences with people with that I've spoken to about this, people that have had these experiences as well. And it's funny, I've always had an interest in the alien things, you know. I would always look at astrology, I would always look at the paranormal. I've seen lots of ghosts from early age. So this is the thing, a lot of people, I would call them the near-death experience community, think that maybe their psychic ability or their sensitivity comes from that particular, because of the experience, right? But I don't know about me, because I've always had them. And I don't know whether the entities are interesting people with these types of abilities, or they want to tap into people like that, or it's because you come in contact with them. Who knows? But I am of the let's say I subscribe to the idea that we're all psychic, and it just takes a little practice, sometimes a lot, but you can reinforce that and wake up your mind, or maybe put your mind to sleep so your abilities can come forth. Anyways, sorry this is taking so long, but yeah, I only wanted to make it about 10 minutes, but it's now nearly a quarter. So if you liked it, subscribe, because I'm gonna make another video in regards to this, and thumbs up if you're interested, okay? So as I say, subscribe, subscribe, and yeah, love yourself, okay? And spread love, please. Don't get stuck in the hatred of other people. We are joy, that's what we are. Okay, it is what we are. We are pure joy in spirit. Okay. Cheers, and I'll see you all, or maybe you'll see me later on.